the Gospel Gamer, and it's recently come to my attention in the news that this game, Doki Doki Literature Club, which looks like the most unlikely game, has been connected to suicides. So, I thought it'd be interesting to have a look at it myself and be able to give an honest explanation of it. I'm streaming at the minute as well, and the very first thing I have to notice is that there was warnings on Steam before I downloaded the game. There's a warning there, and there's another warning. Individuals suffering from anxiety or depression may not have a safe experience playing this game. For content warnings, I have been diagnosed with both anxiety and depression at separate stages of my life, but again, the thing is the game doesn't seem to tell you exactly why this is the case. It looks like a fun anime game or a harem game. So I'm very curious to see what this game really has to offer and if it can actually be attributed to suicide. So, let's continue. You agree that you at least 13 evades. Okay, well, at least we know there's not going to be any sexual content. Yes, I'm not going to get banned from Twitch. And you consent to your exposure of highly disturbing content. Okay, I don't even like that sound effect. That's the most disturbing sound effect so far. I agree. This game looks so wrong if I'm playing with it. Like, see if somebody comes behind me and looks at it. So this game is not suitable for children. Love it. Right, can I please have full screen, please? Thank you, full screen. There we go. Now, if that mucks anything up for you on the stream, y'all could just pop something into the chat for me and let me know. Otherwise, I'm just going to be scummed any minute now. I don't know. Like I said, let me know about the volume as well, because it seems really loud. Let's bring a bit of that Japan back in. Let's just rein some of that in. Okay, well, no. We need a bit of music, because I'm sure it's going to get dead eerie at some point. Alright, new game. Please enter your name. Geo! Yes! It actually lets me do it. I see an annoying girl running toward me from the distance, waving her arms in the air like she's totally oblivious to any attention she might draw to herself. That girl is... here we go. Now I'm going to butcher the names of all of these characters for the entire time I'm going to be streaming this. Okay, I'm going to go for Sayori. Sayori? Yes, no, maybe? Sayori. My neighbor and good friend since we were children. You know, the kind of friend you'd never see yourself making today, but it just seemed kind of works out because you've known each other for so long. We used to walk to school together on days like this, but starting around high school, she would oversleep more and more frequently, and I would get tired of waiting up. Oh, it's a hard knock life for you. But if she's going to chase after me like this, I almost feel better off running away. Oh, is this going to be my first choice? However, I just sigh and idle in front of the crosswalk and let Sayori catch up to me. Oh, dear me. This feels like my lowest point of a gamer ever playing this game. Like, I literally just stopped playing For Honor like a few minutes ago just to start playing this here and streaming it. I was really enjoying myself.
But I caught you this time.
I'm not the voices. So I'm guessing we don't get to see myself as a protagonist. I just get a name. Maybe only because I decided to stop. Wait for you. Well, if it's decision making in this game, I wouldn't be ignoring her, because that's just mean. Huh? That's what she said. Oh dear. Well, if people stare at you for acting weird, then I don't want them to think we're a couple or something. Oh, come on, why am I such a jerk? I didn't make these kind of choices, I wouldn't say that. Don't be fine with that. That's abuse, me even saying that to you. Sayori. But you did did wait for me. I did. Guess you don't have it in you to be mean even if you want to. Yeah, exactly. Whatever you say, Sailor. Okay. We cross the street together, make our way to the school. Okay, as we draw near, the streets become increasingly speckled with our students making the daily commute.
By the way, Gio,
have you decided on a club to join yet? Oh dear. My wife's gonna walk in and she's gonna see this and she's gonna seriously question me, or I'm gonna be in some kind of a trouble here. Have you decided on a club to join yet? A club? I told you already, I'm not really interested in joining any clubs. I haven't been looking either. You calling me a liar? Sayori, that's not cool. You told me you would join a club this year.
I say that every year.
Did I? I'm sure it's possible that I did in one of our many conversations where I dismissively go along with whatever she's going on about. Sayori likes to worry a little too much about me when I'm perfectly content just getting by on my average by spending my free time on games and anime. Yes! Okay, this character's actually a bit more like me. Other differences, is I have a small tribe of children usually in tow, stopping me from watching anime. Alright, I was talking about how I'm worried that you won't learn how to socialize or have any skills before college. Don't you judge me. Online skills are the best skills, right? Am I right? Online skills are the best skills. Your happiness is really important to me, you know. Childhood friend talk. Nobody actually talks like this, though. But I'd die at the thought of you becoming a neat in a few years. And now the embarrassing moment. Where Gio, the gospel gamer, on his debut on YouTube and Twitch, has to Google the word neat because he's literally getting that old. What is a neat? Neat is a young person who is not in education, employment, or training. You learn something new every day. I did not know that. Okay. You trust me, right? I do trust you. Why don't you just become American? I'm terrible at accents. Don't make me keep worrying. Come on. Alright. I kind of like waiting to get to an action sequence here or something, you know, where suddenly there's going to be a crowd of zombies and it's just start blowing them all apart. I look at a few clubs if it makes you happy. No promises, though. Yes. Be as happy as you want. Well, it could be worse. More than that, I'm surprised I even let myself relent to her. Okay. I guess seeing her worry so much about me makes me want to ease her mind at least a little bit, even if she does exaggerate everything inside of her head. You know, for love nor money, folks, you couldn't get me back in a classroom, like, kicking and screaming. See, that scene right there, that's the beginning of a nightmare, okay? That is the beginning of a nightmare for me. I'm like, can't stand that already. School day is as ordinary as ever.
There was no such thing as ordinary school days in my life.
And it's over before I know it. After I pack up my things, I stare blankly at the wall, looking for an ounce of motivation. This is okay. This is starting to connect with me on a deep level. Okay, come on. Clubs. Is that all he says? Clubs. What are you playing, cards? Sayori wants me to check out some clubs. I guess I have no choice but to start with the anime club. No, there are always hipsters in anime clubs. Sorry, I'm being slightly judgmental now. I let myself go. Hello! Sup, pink layered lady. Sorry, I must have come into the classroom while I was spacing out. Don't take drugs, kids. I look around and realize I'm the only one left in the classroom. I thought I'd catch you coming out of the classroom, but I saw you just sitting here spacing out, so I came in. I'll be impressed by that. If you don't need to wait up for me, it's going to be too late for you to get your own club. You see, I did read on one of the articles that I was looking at, I think it was on the Sun of all newspapers, that this does take a really dark turn and about an hour into it, so you all might want to stick by for an hour. Well, I thought you might need some encouragement, so I thought, you know, that makes sense. You know what? Well, that you could come to my club. There's no way I'm going to your club, yeah. I know, right? Why is my character such a jerk? Give me the choice to be able to say my own things. Like, BioWare needs to be doing this game. Sarah is vice president of the literature club. Not that I was ever aware that she had any interest in literature. In fact, I'm 99% sure she only did it because she thought it would be fun to help start a new club. Since she was the first one to show interest after the one who proposed the club, she inherited the title vice president. I said my interest in literature is guaranteed to be even less. Yeah, I'm good into the anime club. Why do you care so much? I kind of told the club yesterday I'd bring in a new member. And Natsuki, I'm just really trying not to butcher these names. And Natsuki made cupcakes and everything. Right. Don't make promises you can't keep. I can't tell if Sarah is really that much of an airhead or if she's just cunning as to have planned all of this out. I hope there's some good checkpoints that I can do in this. I let out a long sigh. Okay. Fine. I'll stop by for a cupcake. Cupcakes. See, that's how us Christians, that's how we do it as well. We get you in with tea and coffee and make sure we always have biscuits out. And, of course, the gospel itself. Okay. And thus today marks a day I sold my soul for a cupcake. We've all been there. Dejectedly, good Scrabble word, followed Sawyer across the hall and upstairs, a section of the school I rarely visit, being generally used for third year classes and activities. Sawyer, full of energy, swings open the classroom door. Again, horror scene of classroom. Everyone, the new member is here. Ugh, cringe. I told you don't call me a new member. Okay, I can see where the problem's gonna be here. Sayori always says nice things about you. Two pink-haired girls? All words escape me in this situation. This club is full of incredibly cute girls. Ah, there it is. And... every man's demise. The girl with a sour attitude, whose name is apparently Natsuki, is the one I don't recognize. Her small figure makes me think she's probably a first year. She's also the one who made cupcakes, according to Sayori. You gotta remember this information, right? This attention to detail. This is what gets you with a woman, okay? You can just ignore her when she gets moody. Sayori says it quietly in my ear, then turns back toward the other girls. Right, okay. Anyway, this is Natsuki, always full of energy. And this is Yuri, the smartest in the club. Who's Yuri? And isn't Yuri a term for something else? Don't say things like that. That's Yuri. Okay, purple hair girl is Yuri. Oh no, you're not going to be able to see that because my face is going to be on Yuri. So I've kind of... hold on a minute. I actually have to see this for myself. So if I just move this over... Sorry, I'm really childish like that. Right, I'll pop you back up there, me. Yeah, that looks about right, actually. Oh. Down about this seer size. Hello. No. Terrible human being. Terrible human being. Right. Anyway. Full screen. Okay. Yuri, who appears comparably more mature in terms, seems to be having a hard time keeping up with people like Surya and Natsuki. Really hope I'm not butchering these names. Oh well, it's nice to meet you both. Right, let's go. And it sounds like you're already Monica. No, I'm butchering that. Right. Oh. Monica. This is the best I can do. So not Japanese. I'm gonna have to, between doing these videos, I'm gonna have to look up these names because I'm sure I'm saying them wrong. And I'm fairly sure that Yuri has a different meaning in Japan. So once again, Google to the rescue here. I've already learned that neat is somebody out of education and employment. Yuri meaning, I know it is in Hebrew. Okay, now we're getting biblical again. This is good. Plus we got this jam of music. In Hebrew, Yuri, or Yuri, which is spelled U-R-I, means the light of God. Hey! God's in this game. Good. In Japanese, depending on the characters used to spell the name, it also means abundant ideals. Pronounce Yuri. Common Japanese female name that may be written with a character for Lily is also the Japanese vocabulary word for Lily. There we go. We are learning things, people. We are learning things. The light of God. Yuri, the light of God. I'm sure that had... Do you know what? I'm just hoping... Well, most people think of Yuri as a girl ex-girl, and the Japanese girl's name is Lily. And yeah, Yuri's a boy's name, I think, in yeah, well, whatever. Okay. Thank goodness I was wrong. It sounds like you're... we've got to go for Monica. Hello, Monica.
I hope my wife doesn't walk up.
We don't know each other. We rarely talk, but we were in the same class last year. Mm-hmm. Monica was probably the most popular girl in class. Smart, beautiful, athletic. Okie dokie. Basically, completely out of my league. There's no such thing as leagues. There is no such thing as leagues. So having her smile at me so genuinely feels a little odd. Oh dear, why do I have to play this kind of character? You too, Monica.
Come, sit down, dear. We made room for you at the table so you can sit next to me or Monica. I'll get the cupcakes.
Oh dear me. So it's basically this has turned into a harem game already. Sorry, I got a little too excited. Then how about I make some tea? Yes, cup of tea, please. Thank you. I will take a cup of tea right now. I really want a cup of tea. This game's already making me want a cup of tea. Girls have a few desks arranged to form a table. As Suri mentioned, it's been widened, so there's one space next to Monica and one space next to Sayori. Natsuki and Yuri walk over to the corner of the room where Natsuki grabs a wrap tray and Yuri opens a closet. Still feeling awkward, I take a seat next to Sayori. Natsuki proudly marches back to the table, tray in hand. Ta-da! Natsuki lifts the foil of the tray to reveal a dozen white fluffy cupcakes decorated to look like little cats. Oh dear me, Hello Kitty. The whiskers are drawn with ice cream and little pieces of chocolate. We're used to make the ears. Oh, come on, please. Just hurry and take one. Sorry. The fact that I'm going to upload this to YouTube is what's making me cringe the most. It's delicious. Sarah talks with her mouth full and has already managed to get icing on her face. Turn the cupcake around in my fingers, looking for the best angle. Take a bite. Natsuki is quiet. I can't help but notice. Is she waiting for me to take a bite? Yes, she is. I finally bite down. Probably could have done this a little bit easier. The icing is sweet and full of flavor. I wonder if she made it herself. This is really good, and I would be a good person to judge that. Thank you, Natsuki. Why are you thanking me? It's not like... Because it's normal to thank somebody if they give you something. Catch yourself on. Haven't I heard of somewhere before? Yes. Harem games. Gotta love them. Where every woman just suddenly collapses at the slightest look, slightest glance. Hey, ladies. And that's it. I give up on Natsuki's weird logic and dismiss the conversation. Okay. What about the literature? Yuri returns to the table carrying a tea set. Yes, good old cup of tea. She carefully places the tea. Oh, come on, man. You keep a whole tea set in this classroom. Yes, it does. I guess. Don't let yourself get intimidated. Yuri's just trying to impress you. I believe you. Thousands wouldn't, but I believe you. Well, tea and reading might not be a pastime for me, but at least I enjoy tea. Who doesn't enjoy tea? Anybody who doesn't, go to a different planet. Faintly smiles herself. What is every... Seriously, this game is set in women back 100 years. Monica raises an eyebrow and smiles at me. So what made you consider the literature club? Same reaction as the character. I was afraid of this question. Something tells me I shouldn't tell Monica that I was practically dragged here by Sayori. Well, I haven't joined a club yet, and Sayori seemed really happy here, so... Awkward moment, that's okay, don't be embarrassed. We'll make sure you feel right at home, okay? As president of the Literature Club, it's my duty to make the club fun and exciting for everyone. Monica, I'm surprised. How come you decided to start your own club? You could probably be a board member for any of the major clubs. Okay. This is not how you actually talk to women, okay? Weren't you a leader of the debate club last year? And that's not how women stand when you're talking to them. Continuing. I'd much rather take something I personally enjoy and make something special out of it. If it encourages others to get into literature, then I'm fulfilling that dream. Monica really is a great leader. Okay, dip. Yuri also nods in agreement. Okay. Then I'm surprised there aren't more people in the club yet. There must be hard to start a new club. You could put it that way. Not many people are very interested in putting out all the effort to start something brand new. It feels like that when you're trying to start off on YouTube and Twitch, I tell you that one for free. Especially when it's something that doesn't grab your attention. Like literature or the gospel. You have to work hard to convince people that you're both fun and worthwhile. Right, okay. But it makes school events, like the festival, that much more important. Mm-hmm. I'm confident that we can all really grow this club before we graduate. Okay, right, everyone, yes, okay, right, we'll do our best. You know what? Everyone enthusiastically agrees. Such different girls all interested in the same thing. Monica must have worked really hard just to find these three. Oh dear, maybe that's why they're also delighted by the idea of a new member joining, though I still don't really know if I can keep up with their level of enthusiasm about literature. So, Gio, what kind of things do you like to read? Well, considering how little I've read these past few years, I don't really have a good way of answering in that. Lord of the Rings. Manga. What was the last manga I read? Ben6VTR. Thank you very much for the follow. Must be doing something, right? What was the last manga I read, though? Must have been a Shonen Jump years ago. I haven't read manga in years. No, I have a manga Bible. Would you believe it? Okay, I know I'm Gio the Gospel Gamer, but I have a manga Bible. Next time I'm doing a stream recording it, I'll make sure I bring it over to you. The manga Bible. And I have the manga Messiah as well. It's also like a manga New Testament. It's brilliant. I'll show it some other time. Anyway, I mutter quietly to myself, half joking. Natsuki's head suddenly perks up. It looks like she wants to say something, but she keeps quiet, because you do not insult manga. Okay, manga's awesome. Not much of a reader, I guess. Well, no, Lord of the Rings. Or, nope, that's me. Bible and Lord of the Rings. Well, that could change. Just actually genuinely can't think of things off the top of my head. Spoke without thinking after seeing Yuri's sad smile. Oh dear me. Anyway, what about you, Yuri? Well, let's see. By the way, most women don't tuck their hands behind their back like that when they're talking to you. It's like, I just... Okay, yeah, that'll... Yuri traces the rim of her teacup with her finger. My favorites are usually novels that build deep and complex fantasy worlds. I like you. The level of creativity and craftsmanship behind them is amazing to me. Agreed. And telling a good story in such a foreign world is equally impressive. I'm trying to remember what the author's name is now. Does the Chronicles of Druss. Druss. Come. Google to the rescue, huh? Here it goes on, clearly passionate about her reading. What is it called? Just the Barbarian, or just the Axeman, just the Legend, David Jamel, that's the one. That was going to annoy me. David Jamel, my favorite author. Couldn't even remember his name though, so that really says a lot about me. She seems so reserved and timid since the moment I walked in, but it's obvious by the way her eyes light up that she finds her comfort in the world of books, not people. You can kind of understand that. But you know, I like a lot of things. Stories with deep psychological elements usually immerse me as well. True. Isn't it amazing how a writer can so deliberately take advantage of your own lack of imagination to completely throw you for a loop? Doesn't happen that often, though. Anyway, I've been reading a lot of horror lately. Ooh, finally we're getting somewhere, maybe. Come on, folks, come on. And we've been reading a lot of horror. I read a horror book once. Don't be goosebumps, because those are terrible. I desperately grasp something I can relate to at the minimal level. At this rate, Yuri might as well be having a conversation with a rock. Why do we always have to play these kind of jerk characters? Oh well. Continuing on. Really? I wouldn't have expected that, Yuri. Come on. For someone as gentle as you. Ah. Dear me. I guess you could say that, but if a story makes me think or takes me to another world, then I really can't put it down. True, Bill. Surreal horror is often very successful at changing the way you look at the world, if only for a brief moment. Silent Hill, that's all I can say. Silent Hill, folks, okay? Anybody else agree with me? Get it in the chat. Seriously, Silent Hill. I know it wasn't a book, but that game practically had to get a whole new wardrobe of underwear just for that. I was way too young to be playing that. I hate horror. Oh, why is that? Well, I just... Natsuki's eyes dart over to me for a split second. Okay. Oh. You should like to write about cute things. You left a piece of scrap paper behind last club meeting. It looked like you were working on a poem called Don't Say It Out Loud! But give that back. Oh. Your cupcakes, your poems. Everything you do is just as cute as you are. Ruffle your hair. Just pat her on the head. Sayori slides up behind Natsuki and puts her hands on her shoulders. I'm not cute, she says. Yeah, okay. Natsuki, you write your own poems. Well, I guess sometimes. Why do you care? I think that's impressive. Why don't you share them sometime? Why not? Natsuki averts her eyes. You wouldn't like them. Why? It's all about death and destruction. Me too, man. Me too. Thank you. Looking forward to seeing the channel develop and grow. Yeah. Like I said, I'm thinking this might be a good starting point because, like I said, of the... Well, being the fact that somebody with anxiety and depression who's actually going to go through a game that apparently this can really mess with them. So, this is a good way for me to document it. You wouldn't like them. Okay. I'm not a very confident writer. It doesn't feel like I'm playing a game, though. It feels like I'm in the middle of a science experiment or something like that there, where... Not a very confident writer yet. My wife is a poet. A very good poet. I understand how Natsuki feels. The music's starting to drive me nuts too. Sharing that level of writing takes more than just confidence. The truest form of writing is writing to oneself. Dear diary, you're awesome. I'll do. You must be willing to open your readers, expose to your vulnerabilities, and show even the deepest reaches of your heart. Do you have writing experience too? No. Oh, come on. People don't talk like this in real life. Maybe if you share some of your work, you can set an example and help Natsuki feel comfortable enough to share hers. Her dark, 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 dark poetry. Yes, I do guess it's the same for yours. We all sit in silence for a moment. Alrighty then. I have an idea, everyone. Natsuki and Yuri look quizzically at Monika. Oh dear me. Let's all go home and write a poem of our own. Then next time we meet, we'll all share them with each other. I'd need my wife for this because I couldn't actually come up with a poem off the top of my head. Do not think I have that in me at all. That way everyone is even. So far, other than pressing the space bar, I don't think my hand is actually needed to move. Maybe that's the idea for... Yeah, I don't know. And I hope not. Isn't that right? Yeah, Monika smiles warmly at me once again. See if her name's not Monika. I'm going to be so scundered. Hold on, there's still one problem. What's that? Now we're back to the original topic of me joining the club. I bluntly come forth with what's been on my mind the entire time. Mom, what dude is going to say no? I never said I would join this club. Sayori may have convinced me to stop by, but I never made any decision. I still have other clubs to look at, and I lose my train of thought. All four girls stare back at me with dejected eyes. Yeah, you're in trouble when that happens. Aww. Well, they all just take their shoes off. I'm a bad guy. I'm a bad man. I'm mean. I'm defenseless against these girls. How am I supposed to make a clear-headed decision when it's like this? That is, if writing poems is a price I need to pay in order to spend every day with these beautiful girls, no, thank you. But then again, no. If I were younger, and this was real life, and I were a very funny-faced anime character, probably would. Okay, I've decided then. I'll join the literature club. Yay! One by one, the girls' eyes light up. Yay, I'm so happy. Okay. finally, at least somebody's blunt. If you really just came for the cupcakes, I'd be super pissed. Yes, get it. And that makes it official. Welcome to the Literature Club. Thanks, I guess. I thought there'd be more choices to make, or at least in the conversation sense. Okay, everyone, let's go. I think with that, we can officially end today's meeting on a good note. Everyone remember tonight's assignment, write a poem to bring to the next meeting so we can all share. Monica looks over at me once more. Gio, I look forward to seeing how you express yourself. Hey, yeah, can I really impress the class star Monica with my mediocre writing skills? I already feel the anxiety welling up inside me. I do not. I feel cringeworthy. Meanwhile, the girls continue their chit-chat as Yuri and Natsuki clean up their food. Hey, Gio, since we're already here, do you want to walk home together? That's right, Sarah and I never walk home together anymore because she always stayed after school for clubs. Makes sense. Might as well. Yay. That's a very good idea, Sarah. Thank you. Okay. With that, the two of us depart the club room and make our way home. The whole way my mind wanders back and forth between the four girls. Sayori, Natsuki, Yuri, make that sound Russian, and of course, Monica. Will I really be happy spending every day after school in a literature club? Perhaps I'll have the chance to grow closer to one of these girls. Alrighty then, I just need to make the most of my circumstances and I'm sure good fortune will find me, and I guess that starts with writing a poem tonight. Perfect. Right. Now, streamers, not streamers, Twitch people, don't you worry. I'm going to end the recording here a second.